the anger continues to grow across the country. Now, let's tell you that the Indian Medical Association is on a 24-hour nationwide strike with withdrawal of services across the country. Only emergency and casualty services will continue to operate. OPDs, elective surgeries will all be non-operational. All my colleagues are joining me from across the country, but I'm given to understand Neha Hebbale joins me from Bengaluru first. Neha, as far as you were, of course, in conversation with a medical representative there earlier as well, where he went on to say that this has only happened because of the fact that doctors are pushed to be doing this. Because in a, you know, other circumstance, if they had better safety norms at workplaces, we wouldn't have looked at this. Although, of course, the zero impact on ground zero would be a lot more right now from where you're reporting from.
Well, absolutely right, Nivedana. You know, of course, the strike, much like in other parts of the country, has continued over here in Bengaluru as well at the Nimhans Hospital that, you know, we've been reporting for the past about 5 days now, almost, you know, so to speak, of course, even as doctors here continue to sit on strike. Demands are quite clear that they just want safer working spaces in hospitals right now. And as far as, of course, you know, protests over here are concerned, it doesn't seem like it's going to be stopping anytime soon. We're, of course, you know, seeing the manner in which the doctors have been protesting now across the country, not just in Bengaluru. Of course, this is a call that's been given now by the IMA as well. We'll try and quickly speak with a couple of doctors over here now and understand from them how the stir is intensified and when really, of course, you know, we're going to be seeing some resolution from the government. If I can ask you, doctor, we're seeing that it's a nationwide strike that's been on now. It'll be completing a week very soon. I want to ask you, with all OPD services remaining shut across the country today, are you hopeful that the government would hear the message of doctors loud and clear?
Yes, sir. Now that IMA has also joined the protest and called for a 24-hour strike, we are hoping that it stirs up something from within the government and it compels them to come ahead and take a decision regarding this.
Okay. Doctor, I want to ask you as well, you know, I have to ask you, we're seeing how are women doctors reacting to the strike across, you know, there's a lot of solidarity that's come through now, whether it's been from the IMA or the other bodies. Are you hopeful that the government would give in to the demands and hospitals would be made safer spaces for women to work at?
The fight that we're doing today is just not about today, right? It's been past so many years. The fight is not only about women doctors, also about the nation, the world, and for everybody, just not like women or men as such, right? And we have seen, we are hopeful, we are resilient, and history has showed us that if we all stand together, if the entire nation, the entire world stands together, the people in power are bound to bend down. So we are definitely hopeful.
All right, thank you. Well, of course, Nivedana, you know, mounting pressure here now on the government. OPD services, remember, shut down for 24 hours now. Patients, understandably so, of course, are going to now have to move to the emergency there. But will this be enough?
This is Ground Zero Voices and continue to track the impact of on Bengaluru. And like you're rightly pointing out, will that be enough? What's going to happen next is only time is only going to tell us. But let me take that point across to Srishti Atkare joining us from JJ Hospital in Mumbai. Srishti, we saw what our colleagues had to say about different parts as to how they're, of course, coming together from the country to be raising their voices for safety at workplaces and several other key demands. Having said that, what is the impact like from where you're reporting?
Well, of course, right now where we are present is at the JJ Hospital. We have with us resident doctors who are protesting day and night. Yesterday also, they were here at this particular hospital in large numbers. What they are demanding is the basic thing, that is their safety and security. However, today, IMA has also gone on for a strike. OPDs entire nation are closed and people will be facing several issues for the same. We'll try and talk to a few doctors over here. Ma'am, what exactly are your demands? What are you trying to convey to the government as well as the system?
See, their main demands are that the first demand was the investigation to be transferred to a central agency, which has been fulfilled. But the second and foremost demand is to implement a central healthcare protection act so that all the healthcare workers in the nation will be secured and will be safeguarded. And no one would ever in future think of conducting any violence or any kind of such heinous act on any doctor. And if anyone conducts such a crime, there will be a law for it and there will be swift action against it.
Sir, what exactly are your demands? Have you conveyed it to your senior officials also? Also, how are you looking at the situation wherein now OPDs are closed? Is there any problem which is going on in the hospital?
मैम एक्चुअली हमारी डिमांड्स तो यही है कि एक तो जिसके साथ इतना हीनियस क्राइम हुआ है उसको न्याय मिले और दूसरा हमें यह है कि ऐसा दोबारा से रिपीटिशन में ना हो तो ना उसके लिए वापिस से सारी सिक्योरिटी सारे हॉस्पिटल्स में इंश्योर की जाए ताकि किसी और के साथ ये दोबारा से ऐसा में ना अभी प्रॉब्लम्स तो आ रही हैं बट फिर भी क्योंकि अभी सीनियर कंसल्टेंट्स देख रहे हैं ना बट अगर
ओपीडीज में भी देख रहे हैं सीनियर
हाँ जी सीनियर कंसल्टेंट्स ओपीडीज में भी देख रहे हैं बट अगर ना डिमांड्स फुलफिल नहीं होंगी तो दे विल आल्सो ज्वाइन अस ना वेरी नियर
सर ओपीडीज बंद है आज क्या
Just from Mumbai to show us what the impact is looking like from ground zero. But like I mentioned, with the fact that we're going to be also looking at what the impact from across the country is, what has happened in the national capital, my colleague Nikhil Dakwani reports.
So the call which was given by the Indian Medical Association for doctors to observe the suspension of services, that is something which is currently being observed in parts of the capital city. Currently we are reporting from the Safdarjung Hospital, which is one of the prominent healthcare facility in New Delhi. And you can see that this is the picture which is coming in right at this place because the call has been given for the protest, for the suspension of services. So the patients are the ones who are facing the brunt. And to keep a check on the overall safety and security, the paramilitary forces have also been deployed right outside the OPD chamber here at the Safdarjung Hospital. And in fact, we can see some of the women personnel as well, they have been equally deployed here. So on one side, the doctors across the nation, be it from the private facility or the public facility, they are protesting right on the streets. On the other side, the patients are the ones who are facing the problem. Let's take a quick view from the patients. Aapko takleef hui hai koi abhi tak? Aap Safdarjung mein aaye hain, OPD, jaisa ki bataya gaya hai ki hartal rahegi, aaj nahi hoga. Problem
ho rahi hai, bheed bahut hai is samay. इसमें भीड़ बहुत है, नंबर लगा रखे हैं, कम से कम 200 आदमी के बाद का नंबर है
200 आदमी. सो यू कैन इमेजिन द प्लाइट ऑफ द पीपल हु हैव कम हियर. इनफैक्ट वी हैव स्पोकन टू सम ऑफ द पीपल हु हैव टोल्ड अस दैट इवन द बेसिक फैसिलिटीज आर बीइंग डिनाइड बाय दोस पीपल हु आर इन चार्ज ऑफ हियर.
The anger continues to grow across the country. Now, let's tell you that the Indian Medical Association is on a 24-hour nationwide strike with withdrawal of services across the country. Only emergency and casualty services will continue to operate. OPDs, elective surgeries will all be non-operational. All my colleagues are joining me from across the country, but I'm given to understand Neha Hebbale joins me from Bengaluru first. Neha, as far as you were, of course, in conversation with medical representative there earlier as well, where he went on to say that this has only happened because of the fact that doctors are pushed to be doing this, because in a other circumstance, if they had better safety norms at workplaces, we wouldn't have looked at this. Although of course the zero impact on ground zero would be a lot more right now from where you're reporting from.
Well, absolutely right, Nivedana. You know, of course, the strike, much like in other parts of the country, has continued over here in Bengaluru as well at the Nimhans Hospital that, you know, we've been reporting from for the past about 5 days now, almost, you know, so to speak. Of course, even as doctors here continue to sit on strike, demands are quite clear that they just want safer working spaces in hospitals right now. And as far as, of course, you know, protests over here are concerned, it doesn't seem like it's going to be stopping anytime soon. We're, of course, you know, seeing the manner in which the doctors have been protesting now across the country, not latest in Bengaluru. Of course, this is a call that's been given now by the IMA as well. We'll try and quickly speak with a couple of doctors over here now and understand from them how the stir is intensified and when really, of course, you know, we're going to be seeing some resolution from the government. If I can ask you, doctor, we're seeing that it's a nationwide strike that's been on now. It'll be completing a week very soon. I want to ask you, with all OPD services remaining shut across the country today, are you hopeful that the government would hear the message of doctors loud and clear?
Yes, sir. Now that IMA has also joined the protest and called for a 24-hour strike, we are hoping that it stirs up something from within the government and it compels them to come ahead and take a decision regarding this issue.
Okay. Doctor, I want to ask you as well, you know, I have to ask you, we're seeing how are women doctors reacting to the strike across, you know, there's a lot of solidarity that's come through now, whether it's been from the IMA or the other bodies. Are you hopeful that the government would give in to the demands and hospitals would be made safer spaces for women to work at?
The fight that we're doing today is just not about today, right? It's been past so many years. The fight is not only about women doctors, also about the nation, the world, and for everybody, just not like women or men as such, right? And we have seen, we are hopeful, we are resilient, and history has showed us that if we all stand together, if the entire nation, the entire world stands together, the people in power are bound to bend down. So we are definitely hopeful.